Mini chapter 88, the Cosy Score, normal comfy or strange scary newsfeed. As Jaymi soon learns next morning, numerous sources are excited to announce that today Bangdead has rolled out another massive free offering to consumers everywhere. It's the fifth and final major plank of Ain't They Freaky, and the company promises it'll be a popular hit. It's the Cosy Score, normal comfy or strange scary newsfeed. This is a constant stream of images, videos, or pieces of text uploaded from around the world, presenting bite-sized memes of life philosophy, which are rated for reassuringness by any member of the public, using Ain't They Freaky's Freakometer, from a highest score of 10 for most normal comfy, down to a lowest score of 1 for most strange scary. Jaymi lets his gaze wander up and down this newsfeed stream, where new posts are popping up every few seconds, every one of them soon receiving scores and comments from multiple sources. He reads a few posts for half a minute or so. Then he shuts off the newsfeed, looks away from the screen, and closes his eyes. A few minutes later, he opens his programming software. He creates a blank new project file and names it Sixth Beast. Who will this sixth one be? Well, let's see. His previous creation, the Platinum Raven, does achieve that cooler radiance of transcendence he was aiming for, the kind achieved by floating in desert-eyed majesty over hillsides and mountain ranges, with a gaze whose expressionless sharpness spans the width of a grid of city light along a coastline at night. However, didn't she rather start out of nowhere, tending to shimmer up on skylines and hilltop terraces without roots of flesh and love and desperation in any organic self? Granted, when he first created that cool-toned code of hers, he did conclude by lobbing into it a red-hot death wish without warning, there on the oceanfront highway, beneath those sizzling pylon cables, up in the Pacific Coast night above her. And this one hot thing inside her does send down a desert-dry root or two into Earth. But it was hardly the multi-branched rooting of a rich backstory, was it? It was more a future crash to Earth that'll remain forever potential, imprisoned within her. What Jaymi hungers to see in this next and final beast is a complex, visceral backstory that his gaming audience can sink their teeth into. Maybe the Platinum Raven didn't quite add up to the Sermon on the Mount after all. Maybe she's a penultimate rung upon a ladder. So again, who will this sixth beast be? Someone who'll embody not just Jaymi's pointed response to the Cosy Score, normal comfy or strange scary newsfeed, but something wider. His instinctive urge for the fierce beauty of a self-destructive voltage, when any kind of wild beauty is so policed and so forbidden by every glyph and pixel of Ain't They Freaky. After a moment, he consults the general sketch of a certain character in his design for The Imagination Thief, a game in which this character happens always to be referred to as Angel. He polishes the sketch so it reads, quote, Angel Dion is an androgynous creature whose spiteful, sleek, depraved face radiates decadence and damage from its sharp beauty. He is shadowy, effete, both unhealthy and luminous, with a sensual and obsessive quality to him, and his head is a fantastically dark cavern of jagged riches. Though much abused in love and life, he has an ambitious will to power of his own. Jaymi then consults the sketch of this very same character in his design for the Platinum Raven. He polishes this sketch too, so it reads, quote, The resident dancer in the nightclub and Amber's boyfriend is Scorpio, unquote. The reason why Scorpio is named differently across the two games is explained in Jaymi's design for the Platinum Raven. Quote, He worked Santa Monica Boulevard with the other girls, in twos or threes if possible, but often alone. Scorpio was just a working name at first, chosen on a whim to undertake this paying work, in place of the boy name Angel that he'd grown up with in Asbury Park. But since this paying work was the only kind of work he found himself doing, and these girls his only colleagues and friends, he quickly morphed into Scorpio for all purposes. Unquote. Well, okay then, bring it on. Jaymi thinks for a moment longer, then he renames this new project Scorpio. So, here comes a new beast, born into beauty and complexity, a creature of his own love and pain, and half foreseen by the Platinum Raven, too. Regrettable that Scorpio's fierce beauty should be forced to look at and tangle with so ugly a counterbalance as the Cosy Score, normal comfy or strange scary newsfeed. Such limp cosiness and so clunkily unsensuous and clueless a lack of grandeur or voltage. Jaymi is sure Scorpio would have things otherwise. That counterbalance would seem, however, to be compulsory.